I write a play, if it reaches one person in the audience that night, I feel I've succeeded. I'll never write a play that all 1,000 people or 400 people for a smaller theater get. But if one person gets what I'm trying to say, I feel rewarded. So they offered me a job as stage manager. So I got to be a fly on the wall and also get BLT for Jerry Page and Kim Stanley. And I was in a room with Kazan directing. I mean, I really, when I think about my own life, I get very envious, so. For me, they're very different muscles you use. Your job as a book writer is to write a really good play, and the composer and lyricist read it and say, that would be a great song, that would be a great duet, that's a great choral number. And then they cannibalize a lot of your most wonderful lines. And you have to feel grateful. Whereas the play, you're the only author. There's the technical aspect, how it affects the artistic side of things. There's a moment in Anastasia, you know, we thought we were ready to open, and someone came running out and said, we need four more lines here. Terrence, shall I write four lines? I said, why? They said, we've tried with six people. She cannot make the costume change fast enough. We've tried everything. So I had to write up with four convincing lines. The most famous song in the movie was A Journey to the Past. It opens the movie, and I said, it's the perfect act one finale. And I wanted to do an act in Russia, Soviet Russia, with the repression and dark and cold and gloom. And then the second act in Paris, spring light, creativity, Picasso, Stravinsky, nice. The explosion of the arts, women wearing short skirts and bobbed hair. And I thought that would be, oh, that's theatrical. And I created some new characters. The cartoon has a singing albino bat in it. I could not bring much conviction. So it's not about control, it's about finding people you admire and you can learn from. I'm a great believer in you don't want to be the smartest person in the room. You want to learn from your collaborators. Now, they asked me to do it and I said, let me reread the book. I reread it and I said, what a great novel again. It'd make a fabulous musical. We listened to it in six tapes. And I said, the only ones I think are right for this job are the guys who wrote the music. The guys, it's sexist, but I mean, who thought the guys who wrote the music on, say, cassette three. The producer said exactly the same thing, and so did Doctorow. And we opened the envelope, and it said by Lynn Ahrens and Stephen Flaherty. My advice would be to be 100% authentic and write in your own voice. As Oscar Wilde said, be yourself, everybody else is taken. It's very profound, but when you're young, it's hard to
trust that.
To understand that, but I'd say that and work with people who are smarter than you, that you're gonna learn something from.